Hello and welcome back to our channel. I am Danish and you are watching Iraqi Dinar YouTube channel. Hopefully you all will be fine. Let's start today. Iraq's economic landscape is witnessing unprecedented changes under the guidance of Prime Minister al-Sudani and his team, with the Central Bank of Iraq, CBI, implementing a series of strategic shifts aimed at revitalizing the economy. Recently, al-Sudani's advisor outlined a pivotal new step by the CBI, which began on October 24 with a notable reduction in its monetary policy interest rate. By lowering the rate from 7.5% to 5.5%, the bank is aiming for an expansionary policy that will stimulate the money supply. This measure is expected to inject liquidity into the economy, making it easier for businesses to access funding, thus driving economic growth. This reduction represents a 200 basis point shift, a significant change that reflects the government's commitment to enhancing Iraq's financial stability while promoting a pro-growth economic environment. Despite this expansionary approach, the CBI has not overlooked the importance of carefully managing local liquidity levels. This balanced approach is evident through what the CBI describes as high-level sterilization operations. These operations are being carried out by issuing what are known as Islamic Certificates of Deposit, CDs. Classified as sovereign debts, these instruments can be monetized or discounted in the secondary market, offering investors lucrative opportunities with returns of 4% for a 14-day period and 5.5% for 182 days. These certificates represent a safe investment vehicle within Iraq, especially for businesses and individuals seeking reliable short to mid-term returns. Moreover, these instruments can be utilized as collateral, adding an additional layer of financial security for participants in the banking sector. The recent changes go beyond interest rate adjustments and innovative financial instruments. Al-Sudani's administration has embarked on a broader mission to clean up the swamp, targeting institutions that were profiting illegally from currency exchanges involving the Iraqi dinar and US dollars. Numerous banks accused of exploiting exchange loopholes have been swiftly shut down, marking a significant effort to rid the banking sector of corruption and malpractice. This cleanup also extends to influential political parties that previously held sway over the media and banking industries. By curbing these entities' power, al-Sudani's administration is aiming to restore trust and transparency within Iraq's financial institutions, creating an environment where the rule of law prevails. The commitment to transparency is further symbolized by the CBI's pristine new headquarters, which reflects the government's push for accountability and order. So meticulous is the effort that some insiders, like Intel Group's Frank 26, have described the facility as being so clean you could eat off the floor. The United States Treasury now has a presence on the second floor of this building, underscoring the close collaboration between Iraq and international financial authorities. This partnership is significant, as it reinforces Iraq's aspirations to integrate more fully into the global financial community, while the U.S. Treasury's involvement adds a layer of credibility and support to Iraq's financial reforms. Beyond these internal adjustments, the country is taking concrete steps toward currency reform, with discussions of a redenomination of the Iraqi dinar generating considerable interest. According to experts, the plan to delete the zeros could precede any significant changes in the dinar's exchange rate, resulting in a revaluation that presents Iraq's currency in a more globally favorable light. This redenomination would likely involve the introduction of new banknotes that would replace current high denomination bills, essentially recalibrating the currency to reflect a more stable and robust economy. Importantly, these new banknotes would not carry the three zeros that are currently found on the dinar, signifying a psychological and practical shift toward a stronger and more stable Iraqi currency. Despite the promise of redenomination, Uncertainty lingers among investors and citizens alike regarding the timing and sequence of these changes. There is hope within the community that an exchange rate adjustment will occur before any redenomination, as this could potentially enhance the value of existing dinar holdings. However, as Iraq's financial leadership continues to weigh the best approach, it remains a waiting game, with citizens and stakeholders cautiously optimistic about the future. Iraq is progressing on critical infrastructure projects designed to stimulate economic growth and job creation. Notably, the Iraqi Development Road project has recently completed its initial design phase, signaling Iraq's commitment to infrastructure-led development. The project aims to connect key regions within Iraq, facilitating transportation, trade, and commerce. Such efforts reflect a forward-thinking approach to economic reform, as these initiatives are poised to lay the groundwork for a more diversified and resilient economy. The central bank's recent moves have also included specialized courses aimed at training personnel to operate newly established exchange centers, where citizens can trade in their old 30 notes for the latest currency denominations. These educational programs are crucial for ensuring a smooth transition to the new system, as they empower local workers with the knowledge and skills to manage these exchanges effectively. According to Intel Group reports, the purpose of these centers is to facilitate a seamless currency swap process, allowing Iraqis to adapt gradually to the reformed currency system. This readiness to engage the public and educate them on financial transitions highlights the CBI's dedication to inclusivity and accessibility in its policy implementations. With the new policies in place, Iraq's official exchange rates reflect a tightly controlled system. The selling price of documentary credits and international settlements for electronic cards currently stands at 1,310 dinars per US dollar, while the selling price of remittances abroad is also set at 1,310 dinars per dollar. Cash sales are priced slightly higher, at 1,350 dinars per dollar, illustrating the government's concerted effort to maintain consistency and control within the currency exchange market. This carefully managed structure is intended to stabilize the dinar and prevent sharp fluctuations, which have historically undermined public confidence in the currency. The culmination of these efforts represents a historic moment for Iraq's financial sector. The government's decisive actions to curb corruption, coupled with strategic monetary policies and infrastructure investments, underscore Iraq's determination to build a secure and thriving economic future. This period of transformation is an exciting time for the country, as it lays the groundwork for a more prosperous and resilient Iraq capable of engaging confidently with the global economy.